Good morning. And welcome to worship here on this Easter morning as we gather together for worship to celebrate the resurrected Lord. It is good to see you all this morning. I want you to use your imaginations with me this morning and imagine the sun moving up over the horizon and you and two companions headed to the tomb to go and anoint the body of the most beautiful and giving friend that you knew. And as you got there and you begin to look around, it was not as you expected. And you began to remember his promises, and you were jolted out of your grief. And you went back to tell the other folks who loved him and followed him. And they looked on you as this was foolishness. But you knew in your heart that there was resurrection. And it began to change within you, and you knew it was going to change within others, and it was going to eventually change the world. So will you join with us now in worship?
Oh, despised and rejected, bearing our sins, my Redeemer is He. And said, Hill nations, stretch out on a tree, and took the nails for me, living He loved me, dying He saved me, buried He carried my sins far away, rising He justified, freely forever.
Join me in prayer, please. Gracious and holy God, we come to celebrate you and what you did and how you lived this life of love and grace and forgiveness. And we celebrate you on this morning as we come together as your people with worship, with song, with word. Be with us now. Amen.
Mercy reigns.
make this transition, it is good to be with you today. I'm not at a microphone yet, but I'll use the loudest voice I have. I am so thankful that Preston reached out to me and had a vision for gathering today. A vision to get our two churches back together for an Easter sunrise service on a Sunday morning. None of us knew where we would be on this day. Last Easter. None of us knew that the week after Easter we would see a change in the opportunity for larger gatherings of people. And I, for one, am looking forward to that as we move to the Sunday after Easter. And we begin to see life in our churches change again. New life, new opportunities as we move forward. It is a joy to be here on a cold Sunday morning. I don't think I've had a Sunday morning here in Jasper yet that wasn't cold for a sunrise service. But it is still good to be together. This morning, I'm going to share with you some thoughts and a message from the Gospel of Mark. Now, the Gospel of Mark's rendition of the resurrection is not often the one that we read. And we're going to talk a little bit about why that is. But hear the words this morning from the Gospel of Mark in the 16th chapter, beginning with verse 1 and reading through verse 8. And I'm reading from the New Living Translation. Saturday evening, when the Sabbath ended, Mary Magdalene, Mary the mother of James, and Salome went out and purchased burial spices so they could anoint Jesus' body. Very early on Sunday morning, just at sunrise, they went to the tomb. On the way, they were asking each other, "Who will roll away the stone for us from the entrance of the tomb?" But as they arrived, they looked up and saw that the stone, which was very large, had already been rolled aside. When they entered the tomb, they saw a young man clothed in white robe, sitting on the right side. The women were shocked, but the angel said, "Don't be alarmed. You are looking for Jesus of Nazareth, who was crucified. He isn't here. He is risen from the dead. Look, this is where they laid his body. Now go and tell his disciples, including Peter, that Jesus is going ahead of you to Galilee. You will see him there just as he told you before he died." The women fled from the tomb, trembling and bewildered. And they said nothing to anyone because they were too frightened. We give thanks to God for the reading and the hearing for the words from the Gospel of Mark this day as we pray. Gracious and almighty God, as we consider the words found in the Gospel of Mark, and as we consider the meaning of this day, open our hearts and our minds to experience your grace. For this we ask in your gracious and holy name. Amen. I don't know if you've ever heard this before. You probably have. But Easter Sunday is one of the hardest Sundays to preach. The reason is because it has such great meaning for everybody. It has such great importance in our Christian faith. And it is often difficult to find the right words to share and to know and to show those feelings. This day of resurrection has such importance. And everyone sees it as an important time. This event makes Jesus different, sets him apart. It celebrates the power and glory of God. But when we read our text for the day, it does not have any celebration. The women who left the tomb left in fear, and they told no one. That's a scary thought, isn't it? A scary thought. What if no one had been told? What if no one had known? A minister shared these words with that sentiment in mind from the Gospel of Mark. He wrote, "Scary news. The original ending of Mark's Gospel pictures the women leaving the tomb afraid, telling no one, not a word, not a whisper. Scary news." Mark's ending is the antidote to all the cheap Easter piety. Mark does not allow even one glib alleluia. Mark's Easter sermon is this: the death of death is the scariest death of all. For if the sum total of who Christ is equals only his birth, plus his life, plus his earthly ministry, plus his death, then the world can go about its business in its usual ways. Now and then, remembering the good things that a decent man once did, but never taking them too seriously. A memorial plaque, a commemorative stamp, making his birthday a national holiday, those in time might find support even from his opponents. After all, they had won. Victors can be gracious to enemies who lie dead. And if Christ is dead, and we are his followers, then all we have to do is work through our grief and remember as best we can what our friend did and said. But if Christ is alive, then the work of Christ is not finished. We will have to dry our tears of grief and see where Christ will lead us next. The future is open as the tomb. Nothing is as we thought. Everything is changed, utterly changed. Scary news. Jesus' death paid the price for our sin. With his suffering, he proved that God can understand our suffering. And with his resurrection, new life was given, not only to Jesus, but to all of us who believe in him as well. The resurrection made Jesus and Christianity more than an event in history. Resurrection brought the living God back into the world. It made Jesus more than a moral leader or a good man. It showed the divinity of Jesus. It showed the power and strength of God. It also showed God's love and involvement in the world. Today we celebrate this wonderful event. We celebrate this event with new clothes and new toys and candy and bunnies and eggs, fellowship and song. But will we celebrate this Easter with a renewal of our lives? Well, we celebrate Easter with a renewal of our lives. Does Easter make a difference in who we are and what we believe? Does it change anything about us every single year? Will we take hold of resurrection this morning and make it ours? Each of us have something within us that needs to feel the spirit of this day. The renewal. The new. The life. We need to feel the spirit of this day. Will we receive it? Will we make it part of who we are? Or will we just let it pass us by? Today is a day of celebration. It's a day of resurrection. Will we allow God's love and grace be reborn in our lives, fresh and new, on this day? Will we strive to make a difference in how we live and how we treat one another and how we show the love and grace of God? Or will we be like the women in the end of the Gospel of Mark? Will we leave scared and afraid and tell no one? How will we experience this day? The beauty of the sunshine. How will we experience this day? The day of resurrection. The day that points to the power of God. The day that brings new life into each and every one of us. How will we experience this day? The choice and the decision is ours. Does Easter truly make a difference in who we are? And do we show and share that with the folks around us? Today is a new opportunity. Today is a new opportunity to experience Easter fresh and new. Will we run from the tomb afraid, or will we share the good news with all that we see and meet? Let us pray. Gracious and almighty God, as we contemplate and consider this day, open our hearts and minds to experience your presence. Help us to grab hold to the meaning of this day. To experience a resurrection within our own lives. Fresh and new. Help us to be the people you call us to be. For this I pray in your gracious and holy name. Amen.
So let us leave here as Easter people, knowing that God has made a difference in our life, so we can go out and love and care and help people to help them realize that there is a God that loves them more than they can ever imagine. Go now in peace. Amen.